Oh, that's why.
Yeah, it gets a little more difficult. The game goes on.
Alright, Batrider first ban from Ad Finem. That's pretty standard. Na'Vi played it both. Was it 2 out of 3 or all 3 games against Wings? I'm trying
all
to remember.
Three game. Oh,
all
two games. Two
yeah,
games.
Yeah, 2 games.
That's probably one of their favorite heroes, Batrider. So.
It also removes their immediate follow-up on of the Wisp, so. Na'Vi probably, they don't want to give the second pick, like, Wisp plus Batrider.
Do you guys remember the first two bans in the first game?
I remember Ricky being one of them.
It was
no, Ricky didn't get banned.
Wisp, Nice Stalker. I think it was Batrider.
Batrider Beast?
Was it Beast? Okay. Might have been Beast.
I think it was like Bat Beast, Wisp, Night Stalker, or something.
Okay. Hmm. So it looks like both teams are.
Not in that order, but.
Yeah, it was. Those are the bans, I think.
Na'Vi are definitely switching things up, and they've decided that Ricky was a big problem.
I mean, I hope either team felt good about their game last game. I hope they both kind of changed something.
Yeah.
That was very.
It seemed kind of clumsy
weird.
For both
it
teams.
It was very clumsy.
I think Na'Vi had a good game going at the beginning, right? Like they.
Yeah, Dindy was owning everyone.
Yeah, they were very far ahead. They were doing well. I think Advin were making some mistakes that maybe shouldn't have been made, and Na'Vi got really far ahead. And then Na'Vi decided to make some of those mistakes, and things went back and forth.
Yeah, I felt like kind of Na'Vi missed the first window, which you have with like Terrorblade Manta plus whatever. Like you probably want to try and get Rex around that time. They missed that, but instead tried. I think it just Advin I'm getting caught out. Their Void got really underfarmed, and they couldn't really deal with TB later on.
So we have Batrider and Beastmaster banned. So you guys are saying that was the same, or
yeah,
no, it was Wisp Night Stalker.
So it's completely different, right? So those were Na'Vi's bans last.
So Ad Finem I think was like Bat Night Stalker, and then Na'Vi was like Beast Wisp.
All right,
I think is what it was.
Glad they banned the Ricky. That hero was definitely super annoying.
Yeah.
To play against.
The cloud won them some.
Yeah, you don't really notice it, but the cloud is warning everyone.
Yeah, it kind of forced TB to have Hurricane Pike on him for quite a long time. He didn't want to just have to BKB the Ricky Smoker, the Know-Nothing for the Timber.
Just a really annoying hero to play against. Some people are just really good at just being invisible.
Yeah, just being really, really annoying. So if you're an annoying person and you know so, then try playing Ricky, I guess.
Are you really good at Ricky?
Yeah, I'm brilliant. I think
really
I played it like once since the change. I went like 4-9. That was in the first 10 minutes.
How come only British people say brilliant?
Brilliant.
No one else.
The word brilliant is absolutely brilliant.
It's not the same, you know, on the
it's
accent.
I guess.
It's not.
How I've always said it.
Not the same effect.
Alright, ban from Wisp
so
from Na'Vi. Ad Finem do not get their Wisp Slark, Wisp Tiny.
Epidem or
almost whatever.
Dire first pick again.
So this was the same?
Yeah.
You're
going to
see Void?
Na'Vi
no, just ET.
Na'Vi really values Radiant, I guess. They must have picked Radiant. They had to have at least once.
Yep.
Apparently they vetoed Skylark playing Void this game.
Yeah, I mean. It wasn't even his fault, really. Like, they drafted Void first pick, and then they picked four, or like, three melee heroes. And he's like, what do I do? Who do I chrono?
His chronos were hard to kind of execute as a team, just because, oh, hey, I got five heroes.
What? All right, Sand King, Dazzle.
So they're really high on the Sand King hero now, Na'Vi. I do know that both General and Dendi, I believe, were spamming it in pubs.
It'll go every game. It'll go every lane.
Yep.
They'll probably do some safe lane Sand King. They'll do some off lane Sand King. Like dual lane, they'll do mid Sand King.
Mm-hmm. So
Sand King's just kind of really flexible.
Maybe Soneko could do Sand King too.
Right? Yeah, they could do that.
Yeah. Maybe not as common, but
I don't know if support what they'll do with it. I guess he just stacks.
I don't know either.
Does Soneko play the Dazzle? Y'all know?
I think art style Dazzle? Hello?
I think Soneko is probably more likely to play a number. It could be either way. So, is a Void likely for Ad Finem? Again, they could. But
I mean, it's already better because they have this Elder Titan to combo with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Darkseid,
they're passing by.
No Void, guys. No, thank you.
Na'Vi probably going to ban, like... I'm trying to think. Do you want to ban mid-heroes at this point? Things that Sand King can't really do anything to? Or do you just don't really bother because you can put Sand King anywhere?
I think Na'Vi's ban should be probably more focused towards middle heroes, I think.
Alright, they ban the Void. They...
Interesting.
Yeah, they could
they
just
ban
do
the
safe
Void against
Void.
Elder Titan, Darkseer.
I don't know if Void Darkseer is the...
I think we tried that a few times.
Yeah, we tried that and it didn't really work out too well.
Turns out when you have an entire team of melee heroes, it doesn't work
you
so well.
You end up chroning your team, yeah.
Like, cool. We saw that last game, too.
Yeah, he chroned three of his team, but since ET used ulti before that, it didn't really make that much of a difference, and I think they still won that fight.
Yeah, but right. It's like it's really hard to just get any good chrono off.
It's one of those moments where you're just like, I got the chrono, guys, and everyone's just on the side of it, like, all silent. You're like, oh, sorry.
So, all right, bans from Adfinum. Like, what do you even want to ban against Na'Vi? Like, they had the Terrorblade last game. They picked that in the second phase, I think.
Well, right now you don't have really any catch. Yeah. Darkseer, Auto Titan. Probably yes. Some more mobile heroes. Ooh, anime is going on over there.
Oh, boy.
That's like the ritual.
Yeah, the same one, I think.
Which one was it?
The basketball one.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Right. Kuroko no Basket. That yes. is the name given by the style. I wouldn't know that.
Who's the anime watcher on Adfinum?
Madara.
Madara?
Yeah, definitely.
It's definitely.
Madara.
Look at his picture.
I can't see those pictures.
Yeah, he's got the anime
you know
picture. Madara right
is? No. That's an anime.
What is it with like everyone changing their name to characters from Kuroko no Basket and getting like 9K, 8K? Everyone seems to be doing it. It was Arteezy, Miracle Book.
I mean, you get
it.
Inspired, right?
Yeah, I guess it's the inspiration factor. Although I've never really been inspired by Japanese cartoons to do much of anything useful.
I mean, they're not cartoons, so. Right?
Yeah, dude, come on.
Oh, sorry, Chinese.
Disrespect.
Cartoons.
They're like stories.
Oh, stories, okay.
They're fairy tales, you know? That inspire you to be a better person. A greater person.
So, I don't know what Adfinim are going to kind of expect from Na'Vi. Na'Vi have that kind of whole really aggressive early game strategy going for them. They'll always run at you, so... But this Dazzle Sand King is a little bit different from what we've seen from them before, I think. Have they played Dazzle yet at all? I don't remember.
They've played it too much, actually, no. But it's pretty nice versus ET, obviously. You have the armor. You can sustain a push against all the Astral Spirit Stomps and things like that. You
and
can counter Natural Order.
Adfinim did also ban out the Huskar to kind of...
Yeah. You don't want to get
Dazzle
Huskar.
That's a good ban. Yeah. I like that ban.
Yeah.
No one likes fighting against Huskar.
It's a dumb concept.
Kind of, yeah. I'm just trying to wonder if Adfinum are going to go for like their Puck AM, which they did
they
versus...
Puck. Yeah, they always fourth bans Puck versus Adfinum.
So Adfinum might still go for maybe the Anti-Mage or something similar, just somehow carry, because that was what they had the best luck with against Liquid, I remember. They won their first game by just having a really farmed Madara AM.
I think Sand King does pretty well against AM, at least. He's got like the insta-stun, laning.
Oh.
It's fairly easy.
Huh.
Juggernaut. So Juggernaut could be either mid or safe lane, but they did run... So Adfinim played safe lane Jug last time against Darkseer, I think, right? Yeah, it was against Darkseer. And that's a pretty easy lane for Juggernaut to...
Well, they played against like some TB aggro tri lane or something.
Oh.
It was TB dual lane.
Yeah, it was TB. Okay. They just sent him up in the dual lane and then Darkseer kind of didn't really help.
I don't think Dundee plays much mid Juggernaut. I think that's probably the Jirah hero.
Yeah, but he will play mid-Juggernaut.
He'll play if it's bad.
Yeah. He'll play anything, apparently.
Yep. Okay, Shadow Demon coming out from Adfinum.
I just don't think they think it's very strong mid.
Yep. Shadow Demon's pretty... like he's almost a natural counter to Jug, in a way. You've got Disruption against the Omni. You can scout out. You can get Vision for where Sand King is with Shadow Poison sometimes. He's got the Purge, which you can use to counter the spin. And Oracle. All right, Dazzle,
oh boy.
Oracle.
This
may
is
be disgusting.
This is Soneko's signature. He plays... pretty much one of the only Oracle pickers that Na'Vi is.
I can't think of any other Oracle pickers. Do you know any?
Yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah.
They're very rare.
They really are. Like, who really is willing to cause that much pain and suffering to anyone else?
The guy that buys, like, Null Talisman and goes to the middle lane, right?
Yeah. he just starts slapping the enemy mid hero
like
for
a
2
bane.
Minutes. What do you even do?
He's a Skyra.
His base attack time is so low.
It's also really good against Darkseer to purge the Ion Shells. There's no way Adfinim can play aggressively on this lane with the Oracle, Dazzle, Juggernaut defensive tri-lane. I'd expect Oracle and Sand King maybe to kind of lane top or play more aggressive, maybe a dual lane situation. Maybe Dazzle. I think Dazzle, Sand King, and Oracle Jug will work a little bit better. Than
yeah,
the
I
other
don't think you need both the Oracle and the Dazzle to be with the Jug on bot lane. I think the Oracle does enough versus the Darkseer. But you could just guarantee the Jug's farm entirely, but... I don't think that's really necessary. And you can move one of the supports to top and add some threat to the Sand King.
They don't really have anyone to combo Ion Shell with.
Yeah, it's kind of...
They don't have stuns.
They don't really have anything for
Nautis
stop, right?
Na'Vi doesn't have stuns either, I guess. They just have
heals.
They
have a Sand King stun. It's pretty reliable.
Alright. They have one stun.
One stun. 1-0, huh?
Because normally when you pick Doxy, you want like an Ember or Ricky or Bounty or any one of these, or like Spirit Breaker even sometimes, just to kind of run around with Iron Shaw. But
maybe they might last pick Sven or something to kind of compensate for that.
Yeah, but then I don't really think it's that good of a Sven game. Just trying to figure out, because I think I probably want to pick something kind of greedy. Because they're obviously not going to be able to contest the Drugs farm if they choose to put Drug on safe lane.
They should be worried about their safe lane too.
Oh, Terrorblade, there we go.
Yeah, they want an illusion hero for sure.
Yep.
They don't have a way of killing it at Na'Vi.
I think the main thing for Aphenom is making sure this Darkseid gets something, because he's going to have a hard lane, and I'm not really sure if he's going to have access to his own jungle, because the Sand King might, or the Sand King or Oracle might decide to mess with him a bit.
So this would last hero be their mid hero probably to go against Death Prophet. We've seen Dendi play a lot of different heroes this tournament. Maybe Tinker, maybe Windrunner, all those heroes.
Oh,
are
Tinker is really
Tinker is probably really good here.
Yeah,
huh?
Tinker's it's a really good Tinker game.
Adfinim have no stuns to kind of punish.
Ember Spirit, okay. Well, it's not awful versus the Terrorblade. It's pretty good versus ET Darkseer. Like they have no reliable catch
Na'Vi.
On
him. Dendi never lanes alone. He's gonna have a Sunaco in his lane.
Yeah.
Do you think the Oracle start mid?
Yeah, he has to secure the lane for the Ember,
sure.
Otherwise it's almost impossible.
I don't think it's that bad anymore after they nerfed like the base siphon like over and over and over again.
Wait, so does it not even cancel level? So at what level can you not have it cancelled by the siphon, well, the Flame Guard?
Wait, what?
So if I have like level 2 Flame Guard, at what point can I not have it anymore versus the siphon? Does it take it off really quickly? Or?
No, it takes a while now because the block is like what at level 2 it's like 200 or something, and the siphon base damage is like 10 or something. It's really, really bad. Mm. It takes quite a while. Like, once you have level 3 Flame Guard, the DP, like, it's almost impossible to take it off.
Yeah, and Ember doesn't have max HP very high either, so it doesn't really, like, scale.
Yeah. And so, like, once you... He went Stout Shield or whatever, so he sort of just, like, presses Flame Guard and pushes the wave out.
All right, so it looks like it does 14 base damage.
Yeah, Stitura playing Ember, so he's going to be going safe lane. They're going to put the mid-jug. Mid-jug is a pretty nice matchup.
They swapped,
DP.
Actually. Dendi picked up the Ember to begin with.
What?
And then they swapped.
Yeah,
okay.
Mid Juggernaut, huh?
So maybe there's some sort of mind game going on there.
Hmm. Jug is pretty adverse DP mid.
Yeah,
knowing Na'Vi, they probably just have a better set than one of the heroes.
Yeah, something like that. Like
do you guys see that?
Yeah.
It's pretty nice.
No set. Oh, man.
Yeah, it doesn't show, I think. But
no,
he's
that's definitely
he's
that's the
yeah,
set.
He's got like the rapiers and the new set. So
Artstyle is the one with items this game. So Artstyle has Stick, Tango, Salve, and Soneko bought the wards and everything else. So I think this means that Artstyle is planning on moving a little bit more than the...
Yeah, you kind of have to put the Oracle bottom since the Dark's here.
Yep. And he also has a Stick, so I think he's planning on laning top, just dual laning straight up with Dazzle and Sand King.
That's a pretty strong dual lane, Dazzle, Sand King.
Yeah, I'm just kind of wondering if Na'Vi can actually do anything to contest this Terrorblade, because the Sand King could just try and walk up there.
This is pretty strong.
They can when Terrorblade isn't that meta. He'll use it first, like two waves, and then he'll go down, and then no more meta.
Yeah, if they get like level 3 on Sand King, and then they move the Dazzle up when he gets level 2, they could probably challenge him for a few waves. Make him a bit less likely to get free farm, but the Ura's just kind of try and zone out from people from bot rune. Are they going to give the rune to DP? Yeah.
So, you played the Sand King offlane, right, Moo?
Mm-hmm.
Is this enjoyable? Is this hard? How's it work? We haven't seen this hero much, so...
I mean, you're going to be
sad?
For, like, a couple minutes. And
okay.
Then once meta's down for the first time, you should be fine.
It's like
he has one set of regen, so...
Yeah, he's going to rush Tranquils.
Okay, so I don't think he's... Is he planning on? I guess he has a Dazzle going to be with him, so he's going to get healed.
They're going to play really aggressive, and then hopefully he gets Tranquils or Boots really quickly, and then he doesn't get right-clicked by the Shadow Demon, and they wait out the Terrorblade. But Terrorblade can't tank one Caustic, but it's like half his health, so it's pretty annoying.
Yeah, and general skilling the Caustic level 1, and this is really painful as a support hero. You're getting hit by this Caustic, it's like 20% slow.
Oh no!
What a stomp.
Why are they going for Dazzle?
I think they get... both of them hit here. Yeah. They can't kill either because they only have one stun.
They could have killed.
They could have definitely killed the Sanking though. They just chose to try to split it up and maybe.
They
get both.
Thought he had stun, I guess.
Yeah.
And then they.
I think they thought the stomp would last longer than it was. He wanted to like optimize the sleep duration or whatever.
I have no idea.
Yeah, that was just a bit strange, I think. Oh, General gets a self canceled. That's rough.
So this AM's already looking pretty hard for Na'Vi. They've burned through a lot of their regen.
Oh no.
General looks like
he's dead
crazy.
Now.
Meta's gonna last a little bit longer. It's out now. Oh. The poison, he has three stacks.
Yeah, there we go. Oh so this top lane is not quite working out as well as Na'Vi
It's fine though, because the supports are out of mana, or out of regen.
Yep. And now
Meta is down, so they can just sit there.
Sanking will just TP back up there, and now he'll have a much better time.
Yeah.
All right.
Is this how you win your lanes?
This
you
is
a die once.
Tactical feed.
All right.
Look, now he has a fairy fire. No way he's dying.
He's kind of paying attention to middle. Death Prophet's out farming him for the first few waves. It's probably pretty expected. Jug can't really do that much to contest. But later on, when Jug gets high levels in spin, maybe gets boots, you can threaten a kill with some rotation.
I mean, when Jug's 6, it's so hard for the DP not to die, actually. Because you can, the Jug can push in the wave.
Oh.
They've got chains on Ember, so
what's happening? This Darkseer is a man.
Yeah. The slain is not as over. Like, it's not that one-sided for the Darkseer. If he plays this right, it's really hard for Oracle to kind of right-click him down.
So, I'm just looking at DP now. Yeah, he's sitting on 15 CS versus 8, so assuming that... Okay, he's got the double null, so he's probably going to be going Veil straight after his one boots bottle.
Buck really likes this double null thing.
Yeah. I mean, it's... Against Jog, you don't really need, like, faster boots. You can just kind of slap him out of lane with the double null. FM are doing pretty well in two lanes. The Dux has actually got pretty low CS, but he's getting good XP. But he's kind of starting to get really low, and Ember's on full HP 4 mana, so this lane might get harder.
The Oracle's also has to pull his attention.
Oh boy.
Oh man, there's the combo.
My goodness.
Get the Terror Blade. He's gonna pop the.
He's gonna die.
Finale.
He might die too.
Stun's coming back up.
Yeah, he might just be dead.
Stun. He's dead.
Second caustic
he's
coming.
He's gonna get a stomp. No.
Punched.
Wow. This is a very scary
game. Oh yeah,
game.
Go yep. 3, Dobby!
Wait, what?
Then he needs to be careful.
What's he doing?
He's okay.
Oh.
He's got fairy.
Oh, I thought somebody... I thought the Thug DD did not.
So, Thug now has no regen. Yeah, there's. Oh, he has something coming.
What is General doing, guys?
General's just...
This is how you play Sanking.
They can't kill him.
Isn't
he's just immortal.
Yeah, you just kind of run around.
You just run at them. And hope something good happens.
I mean, the tactical feed worked out pretty well.
Do you ever plan that? Like, you know, I'm just gonna burn all their regen?
I'm just like, I'm gonna go die in my lane and come back and win.
I'm kinda getting worried for Dendi here. Like, this is actually, he's getting to the point where he won't reliably be able to kill him at level 6, because DP's getting enough denies and enough farm that she may just be able to ignore the lane after that and just kinda go farm jungle and...
This DP has almost every creep.
Yeah. What level is the Jug?
Should be level 4, five. I think, now.
4?
Yeah, he's not even level 5 yet.
So once he's 5, he can just spin down every wave.
It's still not going quite as Dendi would like.
This DP is extremely rich.
Mm-hmm. Dendi's abusing the solution rune to get some denies.
It's a pretty good DP game, like mid game as well. They don't really have a lot of ways to burst them, other than like Oracle stuff with a Sand King stun.
Yeah, I think Na'Vi want to take pretty drawn out fights.
Get him, Sand King!
This is going to be a big... Yeah.
He's owning.
This Terrorblade's dead.
Right click them.
Punch.
This Dazzle also has...
Dazzle lives here.
Our style's
so
alive.
Bad
yeah,
them.
Maybe next time's also dead too.
Our style's still alive.
Oh my goodness.
And Spartan's going to die if he gets
he's
the right
got
click
a
off.
Six stick, yeah.
Spartan's dead.
Oh.
He's dead.
Stomp.
No, he's not. Nice.
Oh, he's got
he's
tango.
Real speedy.
He's got the tango.
Hey, I'm
General is going for it. Is he going to mango and stun up?
Yes. No, he's too fast. Yeah,
he's got Tranquils.
I mean, that's a great trade still. TB and Shadow Demon for the Dazzle.
Did he meta there or no?
Yeah,
he did.
I think Advent are really underestimating. They probably don't have as much experience playing against the Sand King hero, at least in the offlane. And General's taking advantage of it.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, they're going in again. Is he just
dead?
Oh, this is
oh,
old.
No.
This dead. Is so bad for Madara.
Dominating. Halfway to blink. Life's good.
Yep. Sankey is Blink? Having the time of his life.
I think
right
you,
away?
You definitely. I think you buy Blink. The Strangles build.
Are they going to go get for the this? Sunny.
Maybe you go the full man mode, get drums, and you run at people.
Some people go like Aether Lens first or something like that, right?
Yeah, but then you don't have Blink.
Yeah, they do not. Yeah. So Dityaraz, level 6, he's going to... Did he cancel this?
Yep.
Oh. Is he
he's dead.
He's still dead.
Yeah.
Put your spirit down so you can remnant back after you die.
Nope. Not quite optimal play. So CCNC.
Well, he'd have to turn for that, so I guess
he could have just put
put it in front of him.
My god, this tower is dead, guys.
Yep, it's actually just straight up dying to this duel lane. So this duel lane from Navi is really, really working out. Arcstar's getting a lot of XP, General's getting a massive amount of farm. Madara has almost got no hope of getting any items in the next few minutes. So.
This game doesn't get easier for Terrorblade at any point either.
Like Sand King gets Axe and it gets hard.
Yeah, like this Sand King is one of the best heroes against Terrorblade.
He's one of the Terrorblade counters in the game, and he's getting everything he wants, and Terrorblade's getting almost nothing. So
I think Sand King bought something.
Alright, then he's got the Haste Rune, and he's got level 6. I'm just wondering if he might try and pressure DP here.
He actually went for 2 in Healing Ward on Jug.
I don't know, he might have misskilled. I don't think.
Uh-oh. Is this a... What is going
on? He's trying to get mana so he can Omni Slash.
He has a Mango. But he doesn't want to use it.
This is the most painful slow death I've ever seen.
What's happening?
He used all of his saps. He won't have any when he comes back.
He was desperately trying to stay alive though. He was kind of keeping neutral on HP. He wasn't really losing or gaining anything. The Flame Guard and this Life Drain were on equilibrium.
What's that tower at? The Bati one?
It's on less than half. So this Dux is pressuring the lane quite successfully along with the ET. I think moving the ET down here was a really good move from Epinom.
Now the Sand King is coming to rotate and they're going on the Elder Titan.
Yeah, Sand King's just in.
Yeah.
General's going ham.
He will live, I think.
Yeah, you sure?
Oh no,
Skylar's dead. The Doxy here is really big though.
The Elder Titan got away.
Because like, in the first place, this isn't really a very good Doxy game. You can't really guarantee getting a however many person vacuum. Your illusions are very strong.
Right?
No one to Iron Shell either, so he's got... Like, if this laning phase doesn't really go well, he's got almost no fallback.
Yeah, and he's pretty low on the net worth. He doesn't have many creep kills. He got a lot of XP, but not much gold. So he won't even have his mech timing.
Uh-oh.
Alright, start going in. Shit. Get the poison. Then he's going to Omni Slash straight away. Good disruption.
What a disruption.
Maybe a bit late, but he'll do the job. And just... The Eros is going to calmly farm bot lane. He's probably... He's not going to go for the Aquila or anything like that, probably just go for the straight boots of travel. I think the ET is probably the most happy hero on Epinom right now.
What's happening?
They're just
having a casual stomp.
Yeah. Sometimes you gotta show them who's boss.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, that's true.
And that's level 6 with Mana Boots Brace, so he's just 1v1ing the Terrorblade, and Terrorblade's losing.
Oh, here comes Blink Sand King!
Oh, gosh.
Uh-oh.
He's gonna kill all these... one of these creeps? No, he can't kill any.
Oh my gosh,
that heal bomb.
Yeah, you doubted him. I saw it.
General knows what he's doing.
That's a poor Terrorblade.
That's a 9-minute tranquil blink. Terrorblade is pretty much the opposite. 0-4. He's got his Bassy and Coiling Blade. He could maybe try and farm the jungle, but I think DP is also trying to farm that area. So if you're Terrorblade in this point, like, where do you want to even try to farm? It's getting pretty scary.
Yeah, we have a saying in the Dota. Top left.
Top left, I believe. No, I wouldn't say it's got that bad yet. They still have a farm DP. They could still try and get something with the DPLT.
The worst part is like when you're at Finim, you're thinking about this game, and it's like, we last picked Terrorblade into the Sand King. So they kind of caused this lane by themselves, and... Alright, well...
They're doubting their very existence right now.
Yeah, the Eora's getting more and more farmed. He's going to recover from his slightly pressured lane. From his bad start, he's got almost 50 CS. He's on par with the DP now. So I'd say Na'Vi are pretty... They're in a really, really good position as far as this game goes. Thug's getting closer to his Veil, though.
I don't know if that means very much.
Yeah, I'm not really sure. Because, like, if you're a Thug, right, and you try and walk into a fight with DP ulti, like, the Sand King's going to stun away from you, the Ember's always going to have ulti, the Jug's going to spin, there's always a Grave and an Oracle ulti. Like, you can't reliably expect to kill anything, so you... They're gonna go for this three-man smoke through their own jungle. They do it under the Na'Vi ward.
Right?
Yeah, it was under a Na'Vi ward.
What's the play here, anyways? You just surge
the
TP.
You just surge in, I guess, and try and catch the dazzle.
You probably want to start with to kill the dazzle.
Oh, Na'Vi, no, this is coming.
Wow.
Yep, that was underwhelming.
Na'Vi actually just don't care. They know they're all there.
Oh, the second smoke under the ward. Classic.
So,
he's dead.
And they just kind of run in.
Purge him?
Yes. Oh, well. There's not much spell I could do there. He was between a rock and a hard place. There's a tanking on one side and ulti jog on the other.
If he runs up instead of through the river, then he's fine.
You see Darkseer's items? He has a soul ring and brown boots. So he is struggling a lot, too. This game is hard for pretty much every hero on Advanim, besides the Death Prophet.
Samu, what would Advanim have to do to try and get back into this game at this point?
What do they have to do? You know, I don't really know. If I was them, I'd be very sad.
Alright. So now we've established Advanim's mental state.
And this DP is like, come on, guys. I have Veil and Brown Boots. I'm happy. When you look at your Darkseer, he's got Brown Boots soaring.
Yeah, I kind of get the feeling Advanim's lineup is meant to kind of be trying to push towers at this point. You're already meant to have the other enemy tier 1 or middle. Like, your Terrorblade is meant to be pressuring the top tower, but it's just this dual lane from Na'Vi on top lane really kind of messed with the plans.
I mean, it's every lane, right? Like, Torgon didn't really care. Oh, big Epi coming in. Yep.
No. General doesn't care.
General's just going to go straight for IX2. He's got his point booster.
Yeah, this is the play.
Yeah. Terrorblade, if he gets this Axe anytime soon, then...
Yeah, Aether Wounds isn't worth it. Because Axe does the same thing, just longer range. And then you get caustic on heroes you stun.
Yeah, does it caustics every illusion, right? And you just kill them all, and then they all blow up. So Terrorblade basically loses half his HP guaranteed.
Terrorblade will take 1,000 damage if he has, like, 3 illusions up. It's kind of ridiculous.
It's pretty absurd. Well, the Ducks is just trying to Iron Shell up mid. They just want to make sure that Na'Vi don't have an excuse to group up.
I mean, Dazzle's, like, top net worth on Anfredo, you know?
Yep. And then they Sunder the Ember Spirit. Sineko. Oh,
Sineko's giving him a freebie.
Oh, yeah, you gotta give them something to keep them interested.
He's very optimistic teleport.
You gotta try for it. Tell them you're not afraid to just TP out in their face.
Assert dominance.
Once Dazzle gets his drums, the game begins, though.
So when do we expect to see Na'Vi trying to push down these towers? Because they're really far ahead, but how can they convert this into actually winning the game?
I don't think they have to. They just have to choke out the...
Yeah, their cores are way better than Terrorblade.
Yeah, like, how do they ever, like, push this Sand King out of top? Like, it's impossible.
As long as they don't get picked off too many times. They're getting a little bit overconfident. Digiraz playing, like, 1v4, 1v5, that sort of thing.
They do get the tower in mid as well.
That's the play, right? Like, you all just sit behind a tower and hope Na'Vi dives. And then Na'Vi did dive.
Yeah, we saw from the Wing series that Na'Vi are not reluctant to dive almost anything. The Na'Vi did...
Don't go in.
They did get the ward behind the tier 1 tower.
And it looks like Advanim are going to finish off this bottom tier 1 because of that. Terrorblade's finally getting some much needed gold and overcoming the Dazzle net worth.
Uh-oh.
Oh! Illusion rune combo.
Yeah, Tuck will be going
down. Oh, gosh.
Maybe.
He's balling out of control.
He might not
die.
He's
up a lot.
He's very dead.
He's very dead, yeah.
I mean, sometimes you have to be a
little
optimistic.
And closer to his axe.
He did his best. That was the best you could do in DP.
Yeah, and now Dazzle is richer than every member of Advanim. So it's a good game to be art style if you're Advanim, not so much.
We did see last game that Na'Vi did put together a sizable lead too and kind of made some mistakes and turned the game in the other way. So
Na'Vi had a much more questionable draft though.
Yeah, Na'Vi had a really kind of... It felt kind of... I don't want to say it was bad or it was weird, but it just didn't feel like a typical Na'Vi draft, I'd say.
This game you have Jug, Ember, Sand King versus single core Terrorblade. You know,
none of them ran mid this game.
Yeah.
This is like the first game where Na'Vi didn't have three heroes in the mid lane.
Well, they didn't really need to.
Yeah, but they just had this jug.
They just had the jug that was content not to die, and then this jug's just going to get healing ward later on, and then they're just going to run at towers of them. Because it's not the mid lane that they want to do anything with. The Darkseid just needs to be a little bit zoned, and they need to... Well, they were happy just kind of existing on top lane, but now that Terrorblade's been completely shut down, it doesn't really matter what the results of the other two lanes were.
It's So it looks like they're going to group up with the Healing Ward.
I don't know what to say. They're sitting at the Tier 2 trying to defend Tier 1 because they're so afraid of even split-pushing other sides of the map or anything.
I think Madara needs to... Even if Madara farmed for the next 15 minutes, he wouldn't be able to fight Na'Vi as they are now. It's pretty rough, honestly.
And they just don't have a hero to push out lanes anymore. They have bots Dichiraw, they have his Blink, almost Ag, Sand King. Juggernaut has Phase Boots, Drums, Yasha or something. Any of them can die to a single core on Na'Vi. You can die to the Dazzle at this point.
Yeah, what does Dazzle have right now?
He's got drums.
He's got bongos.
Drum, yep. And he's
almost
the
mech.
One more Terran who'll have that.
He's a monster.
Yeah, I don't think they can even expect to kill any hero on Na'Vi at this point unless they actually dive.
They don't have a stun.
He gets the Sunder off.
I think he'll live because of that. He might.
He didn't
get very far.
I don't think he'll
wall.
Kill him. Yeah. Stun away. General looks dead.
General. Interesting
Blink
stun
be a big
location.
Kill. Yep. Maybe next time is very happy as his Shadow Demon.
Don't
Ooh,
think General really
gold.
Thought that one through, but.
I mean, still, I don't know. That's right. Like a. We're winning death, you know?
Yeah, it doesn't really matter at this point.
What is the Omni Slash for?
Yep.
I'm in.
Shadow Demon is definitely dead. Dichiraw's
they might
just
get
got
the
his win lace. Nope, Tsuneko has reactions of a Panther. Besides, he doesn't want to be stunned today.
What is the reactions of a Panther?
I guess it's pretty fast. I don't know. Just used a random animal that might be quick.
Arstel continuing his split pushing shenanigans.
I mean, what do you even do? You can't send any heroes to challenge this Dazzle.
It's like not even worth challenging the Dazzle.
Yeah, there's no point, but they.
But they kind of have to, because they gotta kill someone.
I mean, Dazzle's got drums, mana boots, mech.
Yeah, it looks like they're going
Look
for
Arstel's under attack.
He doesn't care. He's going in!
He gets the heal bomb.
Sankey's
General.
Coming in. But he
doesn't have
missed
Sunder.
The first few pulses of Epicenter.
What's happening?
Arcel's dying.
Arc-style Dazzle!
SSA Spartan with a briefcase kill.
Spartan would probably die for this.
Yeah, thing. He's got stun up. He's
Doink.
He did his best. He actually he got quite a bit of gold out of that kill.
Is that actually
he was
a
dominating
for Na'Vi.
No, I don't think it was, but they got a massive creep weapon bot.
It's
so
actually
gonna get damage
good
on the tier 2.
Tier 3 dive.
Yeah.
Nope.
Oh boy.
Yeah, we just got Tsuneko hitting the tower with a double creep wave. This tower's gonna go to half HP or less. Dendi's just running around, he's got his face with Yasha. He could go almost anything, really. He could just get a Manta now, or he could go Battle Fury. Like, it doesn't particularly matter. General's getting closer and closer, 800 gold from his Ags.
Kinda he has 20 minute blink Ags. That's the dream.
Really?
Yeah.
Is.
This game's looking kinda grim.
So, there's the mech up now on Dazzle. They're probably gonna look to group up, but at this point, I don't see. Like, Afi never been almost entirely shot out of Thoran jungle. DP is the only one who feels confident enough to set that, because what Na'Vi do is they didn't necessarily kill Terrorblade when they jumped into his jungle, but they did make him feel unsafe, so he didn't actually want to farm there.
I mean, they're not really making any plays, right? They're just. Yeah. They're not comfortable. They don't know what to do, I think, because any other team in this situation, like. You can't really sit here and let the game unfold. Cause you're not going to win that way. You have to do something, even if it's a fucking...
Good silence coming up from Thug. Saves his life from the Omni Slash.
Cancel the stomp.
The Uraz kind of...
Na'Vi are kind of... I think they're in an okay spot.
Oh.
Got the Omni Slash off.
Spartan's almost dead.
Then he's going to try and kill. This is Spartan. Gets slept. Seneko's... Getting
Spite is everywhere. What's happening?
Yeah, this
Thug's
is
gonna
nobody's
go for
Arstyle.
Dead. Arstyle is not dying. Madara TP's in. Arstyle graves himself.
The crack.
Shadow Demon went
We've
down.
Got Shadow Demon coming down in the
yeah,
back
Arstyle
line.
Just
Arstyle just is out of there.
He almost got cracked.
And one person died in all of that.
Sinking with that.
General's gonna have blink up.
He's fine.
Oh, that was very close.
Come on.
He's 150 gold from Ags.
What are they gonna do? Stun him?
So, in all of that, Dark Sibyl was used. The Top Tower lost a bit of HP, but nothing really happened.
Shadow Demon died.
They didn't use ghosts.
Yeah. At this point, Shadow Demon dying isn't the worst thing. He's sitting on bottom of net worth. He doesn't give that much gold.
I mean, again, Na'Vi are happy. Yeah. They just go push out the lanes. They farm more.
This game's looking a little bit more hopeful for Advanim, though. They were...
All right, here we go. Is this the smoke to Roche play?
Yep.
Yeah, they could catch Tsuneko and then try and get Roche.
They have meta. They have ghosts.
I think they're just going to run a Roshan.
Yeah, they're pinging it.
This is
You gotta do something. You have to do something.
Yeah, you have to go for something like this.
This is a good time to. This is a good time to do this too, because they just took a big fight, and then a lot of Na'Vi heroes had to go back.
Well, the general is TPing in mid with his axe completed, I believe. So this is a bit scary.
Yeah.
At any point, they could try and throw a slight into the pit.
General. You can't just sit and relax, though.
Yeah.
Finish Rosh, guys. Alright, Darkseer's dead.
They did get the Aegis on Terrorblade.
They got the Aegis on Terrorblade, so this isn't the worst thing that could happen. Thug is sitting pretty
Thug
low.
Thug needs to live.
He siphons
he's
up
gonna get healed up by his ghost.
The Sand King.
Oh, he's dead. Okay.
Alright, no meta.
TB's dead, too.
TB's dead.
ET's gonna try and save him, but there's not much he can do. Might disrupt him.
They might catch the Shadow Demon, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're gonna catch the Shadow Demon.
That was a nice stun.
Good stun up to the high ground. Please.
Bowlers? Oh, stun.
Have mercy.
I mean,
just call it.
This game was grim since the laning phase.
The crack.
Wow, that axe stun.
Is it Rampage for
Rampage?
Dittura?
Rampage?
Oh, they're leaving it. They're leaving it.
Rampage!
Oh, there we go. Rampage for Dittura. Gives a little laugh at the end.
Just 20-minute Rampage, you know, it's fine.
Yeah, it's as you do. So,
Na'Vi are really running away with this game.
Yeah, they're going to go for the tier 2.
I think it's over.
Athena might be able to have some token defense for the high ground, but.
This is an elimination match. They're not going to GC.
Yeah, they're not going to call it.
At no point are they going to.
But
this guy.
It's pretty sad. Yeah, they went all in on lanes. Like, they have this TB that has to win his lane, or he can't go anywhere because. There's Ember Spirit, there's Juggernaut.
Yeah,
there's
I think
Sanky.
They had to win the lanes enough that they could take one of the two tier 2s on mid or top and then use that to get space for the Terrorblade to farm.
I mean, even if they win the lanes though, like what's the best case scenario? They just walk down a lane?
Yeah, they get like TB Manta in a good time because he's farmed in their jungle for like 5-10 minutes. DP's maybe got a few ultis, they got Roche or something like that, but it's just they can't ever really take map control, even the best case scenario.
Yeah, they have the only way they take map control is TB illusions, which die pretty easily to this Jug and Ember and even
Sand
King.
Have like 3-4 heroes, like Dazzle can actually counter push a TB illusion at this point. Well, obviously at this point, but even if Dazzle had less farm TB, had more, it would be the similar kind of thing. General is going for the Aether Lens after the Axe. So
yeah, why not?
He's going to be stunning
Octarine.
From the other side of the country.
Maybe Octarine Core.
Maybe Lotus Orb?
No. Yeah, he could be.
There's a lot of possibilities.
I just like to see.
None of those sound very good. But
there's nothing like being Sand King stunned from outside of your screen. You're just going to go, what the hell's going on?
This is Darkseer. No plane.
He's stuck to the bot lane. He knows what he wants. Those illusions are very dead. Then he's sitting there with his Manta, phase boots.
Now that I think about it a little bit more, I really like the Dazzle Sand King lane. Because you can always guarantee a kill on all the creeps with a heal bomb. Because the creep waves are going to be meaning. So if he gets the caustic on two or three of the creeps, there's no way.
Just stun through the creep wave after hitting a few of them, and then you heal bomb, and then anything in that area is dead.
Oh, what's happening up here? The Thunder gets off on the Sand King.
Yeah,
but he's fine. He's going to come back in, try to do the stun.
Should
cancel the TP.
Nice. Oh, the stun in downtown. Always wanted to say that.
Well, now you did.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
One good thing came out of this game.
Yeah, Skylark is pressuring the tier 2 bot.
The Darkseer is so sad, right?
Yeah, he's just sitting there alone, just hoping someone cares about it, but Na'Vi don't even care.
Been at the tier 2 for a good 3 minutes now, and hasn't even lost any health.
Yeah, then he's going to go for Diffusal. If Darkseer's life wasn't hard already, and it's getting even worse. He finds maybe next time is booking it, he's just running off to the jungle.
TP.
Just TP out, yeah. He's going to be alright.
Oh,
General,
my
barely misses
goodness.
The stun.
That was blind.
Yeah, it was blind, he had to predict it a bit.
He was going for the show-offy play.
Yeah, he was assuming that Shadow Demon would keep running, or maybe just wait a little bit more to TP. So, it was in the right ballpark. I feel I'm going to ward there on high ground, so they have vision of
this
where the
Dazzle
is.
Might be difficult. I don't think it's...
Is it? They're just a healing ward. They're,
yeah, they're just
going to
walk up with healing ward.
They have three healers.
Alright.
How do you stop Dendi from hitting the tower?
I lied.
Double damage. Ember Spirit.
This looks very easy now.
And Thug is dead.
They all dodged the Earth Splitter.
The Darkseer was one illusion.
There's just red X's on the screen. I don't know what's...
Yeah, I don't know what those are.
Epicenter is being channeled. He just...
Oh, maybe next time. He didn't deserve that.
He didn't even blink in with Epicenter.
Dittura's gonna get ulted under the tower. He's not tanking it though, and he's been Oracle ulted, so
instant
he may be okay.
He might die.
He's fine. Oh, no, he's
Whoa.
Dead. What?
That he didn't.
I guess
Sineko never pressed the heal.
He spent
on
so
him.
Much time inside of Fist that he didn't really have time.
Wait,
does
Grave save you after?
No, it doesn't. No.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it does.
What does it?
Yeah, it does.
Wait.
Grape saves you after
it does.
Overcall.
It does.
Yeah.
It does. I'm pretty sure. Oh.
Yeah. That's
pretty
sick.
They didn't think he was going to die either.
I'm thinking. Oh, sorry. I'm thinking of like disruptions and stuff like that.
I think it does save you. All right. I don't know.
Seems kind of silly.
You'd be saying it doesn't. Grape saves you from everything.
But he should have. So what Tsuneko didn't do was press the heal on Ember while he was.
Yeah, he did. He did heal him.
I don't think he did.
Oh, so
that was one heal
art
from
style
the
did,
dazzle,
but that's not wasn't enough.
And I don't think that was
deny
any from
Tsuneko. Yes.
Deny the tower.
Nice.
Navi really aren't giving anything away at this point, apart from Hedaira, which is. So they didn't actually lose Rexha, so it's not the worst thing.
I mean, they're going to.
Eventually. Oh, okay, smoke coming up.
That was a pretty good hold, though.
General's just going to run through the river. They're going to ignore him. They have no hope of dealing with him.
Navi don't even need to do that, though. They don't have to dive tier 4s. They can just hit the Rex.
Yeah. That was definitely a mistake.
It's just one of those cases.
They have
like
Greaves.
Hit the buildings.
They have Dazzle's Greaves in a
Blightstone.
In a Blightstone. He's going Desolator,
yeah.
I guess. He's tired of his team not hitting tier 3s. He's going to do it himself.
It's probably the most fun you can have is Dazzle.
Yep. You're just immortal.
You're just
no one can
immortal.
Touch you.
Yeah.
You just start hitting anything you want.
I think I'd have 4 points in Poison Touch right now instead of Grave.
Yeah. He hasn't really needed to Grave anyone, honestly.
Alright, here it comes.
This is a pretty big wraparound.
Getting the flank on the
Maybe.
Support heroes. Stomp onto Dazzle, focusing Oracle. Sineko's
just
going to
walk him off.
Crack, hitting nothing. They don't have enough damage to burst down the Oracle.
So
he can't kill
either.
Alright, Oracle and Dazzle burst the world.
The
they're winning.
Dazzle's going to...
Yeah, he's going to die to the Terror
Blade. Did he use Grave?
I don't
think so.
Sineko's
going to pop ulti.
He looks
here comes Sand King, no mana to stun.
This is a bit of a messy fight, but...
Okay.
Oh, Dithyura gets sundered, but Omni Slash not really doing that much. Madara might kill Dendi here.
Dendi is dead.
What
all
is
dead.
Happening? Navi's dead, guys.
Navi is just kind of messing this fight up, I have to say.
Okay.
I think the...
General just hitting the creeps here a bit, don't mind him.
Adfinim did a really good job of getting the wraparound on the Oracle and the Dazzle. They got caught without their team. They lost a little bit, but in the end, they really didn't contribute to that fight.
Nice.
They only used their spells.
Yeah, they had
sloppy.
The Oracle and the Dazzle on different sides of the fights. The Dazzle was dying to the TB plus the ET, and the Oracle was dying to the DP.
Pretty much the way you want fights to go as
yeah,
like
it was
the
like
healer.
Almost the perfect fight for Adfinim, but I think it was more Navi not really knowing how they wanted to take that fight. Because the Dazzle, as you said, he blinked in with no mana.
I mean, Navi's a team of no retreat, right?
Yeah, they just kind of go in. They take whatever fight they're given.
I think they easily could have just let Dazzle die and walk away. But, you know, go in, guys. Let's go.
I don't even think it matters that much. Well, if Adfinim are going to win this game, that's probably what
they
Bam!
Uh-oh.
So maybe one or two more of those, and the fights get a little bit easier.
So at what point do Adfinim stop being able to burst people really quickly? Because right now it seems like it's people getting caught without their Oracle, without the Dazzle, just dying to the ET aura plus TB. But like
TB probably just needs more items. He needs like three or four items to win this game.
I don't
Maybe
know
six
they,
items.
I don't know if they can ever just burst people. They've got no catch.
Yeah, against Dazzle, it's like they're predominantly physical damage through the DP ult and the Terror Blade, so.
What's TB going? Octarine Core, looks like.
Needs health, I guess.
Yeah,
he can get a couple kills. Like, they can kill Ember with Silence or something if he's split pushing by himself.
It has to be, like, Stomp and
he has
Silence.
He has Silence, right? Does that work?
Nah, there's no way.
You have to time it. It's real hard.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really unreliable. I'm just.
It has to be Stomp into Silence, but then it's, like, I don't know.
I mean, Ember has Daedalus if he wants it pretty soon.
He's just going to get it, and then TB's life becomes quite miserable. He can't group up with his illusions at all. SD might just start dying instantly. I've seen him grouping up towards the bot lane. They're kind of chasing our general here. He's silenced up. His blink gets cancelled by Darkseid looking in, and he's all just
right.
dead.
So these are sort of things, right? Like, Navi have been playing this way pretty much the entire time, where one hero goes top, one hero goes mid, one hero goes bottom. They farm all three lanes. But now that Adfinim have a couple of items, they can... kind of punish, especially the Sand King is really easy to punish.
I mean, Sand King's just like stunning into heroes.
Yeah, he's playing cocky, but that's kind of what Adfinim needs for them to win, right? So.
Yeah, the only way Adfinim can win this game is if Navi make these continued like errors of positioning, like getting caught up with Sand King. They're just kind of feeding back this gold advantage that they've gained so far, but Dendi's going to go for Blink Dagger, so he's going to become very difficult to kill. He's probably going to start focusing the ET and SD, jumping over the entire fight to get to them.
There's a haste on Ember, so they might want to...
Oh, Madara's taking a lot of damage.
Jeez.
Did he crit there? I don't think he critted.
No, he critted maybe.
He might get him?
He could go back in. The illusion is definitely dead.
I don't know, Na'Vi can just group up and fight, I think. They seem pretty scared, though.
Yeah, I think they got a little bit shaken by that fight on top, maybe. They're wondering why they lost it.
I think the mid-push is what they're kind of anxious about.
Alright, here we go. They finally caught a hero next time.
That dude's almost dead.
One slight.
Nope, and the stun.
What a stun.
Shadow Demon is...
No surge on this guy. Comes the
pops
stomp.
The wall.
Sineko
is gonna be fine.
They're gonna get more.
Basically
gonna get
two
more.
Free
here
kills.
We go. Stun miss.
The stun misses on
Spartan.
That creep wave is getting massacred.
Spartan looks dead.
Yeah, they have
Adara has a Sunder.
No way out. Sunder's a low HP Ember. Graved and Oracle ulted. Alright, everyone's dead.
Alright. Like,
and TP's gonna buy back. He's gonna try and go through the motions of making it offensive, but.
He has no meta after that new pass.
They have no meta, they have no ghosts. Na'Vi has a healing ward, a little cat shaking its hands.
I gotta say, Na'Vi played that lane extremely well.
Trying to click on it over it so it's difficult. Just look at it.
They're still gonna stay into the end.
They'll ST probably get.
They might try and do something.
At least one set of racks, maybe two. Na'Vi should probably just hit the building.
I mean, our style in general, just shopping in the well.
So what does our style have now? He's got Mana Boots, Guardian Greaves, Vlad, sees the Aura God.
Nice.
Madara gets stunned. Oh, disrupt. General does not have
ult. He's getting low. He's going to blink out here, yep. Ichiro just running through the tier 4s.
He's going to finish him.
Doesn't
he has
care.
No Sunder on.
In comes
Madara.
The kitty cat.
That was a pretty big Earth Splitter. They got a lot of heroes, but...
Maybe next time
Digi-Ra is just doing too much damage.
They can't catch him. They have no stun.
They have nothing to stop this Ember just doing what he wants. Ah, there he goes.
Spartan's dead.
Come on,
curious stun. He's going to use himself up in the...
Alright, here
kill.
Comes the ghost lady. She's back.
She
two rampages?
No
where's
who's
the
back?
Two rampages?
Skylock is hiding in the trees from the Dazzle who's diving
she
his base.
She is not using her spells. Just taunting them.
Seneca's just sitting at the racks going, guys, please hit the buildings.
They're not hitting. Alright, they are...
He's just hitting Thug.
This is good.
Thug
is this is a
animation
good family canceling. Meeting here.
This is nice.
Alright,
oh,
well, yes, the bait. Perfect. Now
Thug
they're killing Thug. Thug is not
damage.
Actually casting spells. Alright, Thug's dead.
Okay. Thug is taking heavy damage.
And
they're going to pay a visit to the well. Sineko blinks in, pops up Oracle ulti. Skylock is going to fall.
Alright, let's see if the grave thing works.
That's
right,
a good
I feel
game.
Like that should have happened at least 15 minutes ago.
Yeah.
That game was a little depressing to watch.
Yeah, it felt like the draft was so one-sided, and also the way that Na'Vi played that top lane. I don't think Adfinam really managed to achieve anything they wanted to do in this game.
I think Adfinam just didn't have any experience against the Sand King in the off.